Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back here to today's edition of The Fishing Teacher, and really appreciate you guys swinging by the channel to check out today's video. I'm gonna give you guys some tips and advice on how to trim a weed guard on a jig today, guys. This is something that you really need to do to almost any jig that you buy. There's a lot of different reasons we're gonna get into today's video. I think it's gonna add up to a lot more fish and a lot less lost jigs for you guys. I'm also, guys, speaking of jigs, I'd like to invite you guys to check out my Block It Throwback Jig by Cumberland Pro Lures, available at Tackle Warehouse. And right now, guys, you can get these at 20% off at Tackle Warehouse through their Black Friday sale. So I'll put my Block It Throwback Jig link in the description of the video. These are all hand-tied rubber skirts, super high quality, hand-tied. Look at that rubber, the way it flares out there in the water, guys. It looks like completely alive in the water, better than silicone. Just, in my opinion, the best jig on the market. So I'll put all that link in the description of the videos if you guys would like to get one. Okay, there's a couple different reasons why you gotta trim guards and why you have to consider a weed guard. Now, this is the way that weed guards are put in a jig, just like this. They're a fiber guard, most of them. They're pretty uniform length, and most of them, depending upon the, you know, how heavy the hook is the diameter of the guards are either smaller or larger. But this particular one, my throwback jig, this is the way it comes from the factory. And I'm not saying you can't catch them like this, but you really need to modify not only my jig, but any other jig out there to maximize it. So what you're wanting out of a weed guard, here's the deal, is you want to have the least amount of guard possible and not get your jig hung up all the time. Because in actuality, in a perfect world, you don't even want a weed guard. It's like a weed guard is an impediment to the hook there. But, you know, when you're fishing around cover, you usually have to have a guard in there. So depending upon the density of the cover, that depends on how much I trim the guard. Now, the first thing that I do on every jig that I have is I level off the guard on the top. So see how it's sort of sitting like that? The first thing I'll do is I'll come parallel to the top of the hook here like that, and I'll just sort of cut it parallel or parallel to the top of the hook. So it's like that. Clean it up a little bit there. Now by doing that, like I said, that puts less material right at the point of the hook, and I got just enough material to cover the hook right there. Now the next thing I do is I flare the guard. So I usually flare it just out a little bit, and what this does is it softens up the guard a little bit, and it disperses the guard a little bit wider over the hook. So it gives you even better, less ability to get hung up like that. And then at this point, I have to make the decision, how much do I want to trim or do I want to trim anything? If I'm flipping this jig right here into heavier cover, like say if I'm flipping it into thick lay down trees or flooded bushes or thick grass beds, I'm going to leave it just like this. I'm going to, you know, level it off on the front. I'm going to spread it apart a little bit and call it good. Now, let's say, for example, I'm pitching like boat dock piers, or I'm pitching lay down logs, or I'm pitching a rocky bank. I don't need this much protection here. So what I'll do is I'll usually come in and I'll take off about 25% of it or so, 25 to 50%. I'll just come in and I'll just cut it off like that. So in this essence, I've taken out probably about 10 strands of the jig, and it's about twice or almost twice as there's half the guards there. So this is going to make it a lot easier to penetrate the guard here and expose the hook as far as the pressure the fish have to put on it. So, and then if I'm fishing, you know, even less cover, say for example, I'm just fishing rock where there's not much to get hung up, I may come in and cut even more off of it. Where I've only got like maybe 10 strands left there. You see like that? There's just enough to barely cover the hook. And normally, even if I'm fishing open water, this is how I leave it, because I always want something down there. I normally never want just a bare hook. So a lot of times I'll trim it down if I'm fishing around like the edges of targets, around rocks or the edges of some type of hard cover, I'll trim it down like that. But the main thing, guys, is flatten that guard out on the top. Even if you don't trim it out, just always flatten it off parallel, and then take the fibers out as needed based upon the type of your cover you're going to fish. Now, this is just going to allow you to have better hookups by far, because, you know, a jig, there's a lot there. You've got the head, you know, you've got the weed guard, you've got a lot of mass there, plus you got your plastic trailer. And the less weed guard that you can have, the better your odds of catching those fish once they do bite. So hope it helps out. We'll talk later.